quiet, please? I can't hear myself. We can't just keep driving around. Dark. So we got to be fine here. At least until we figure out the next move. No, no, no. We need to keep going. We need to get out of the state. Maybe even out of this country. Why don't you clean yourself up? And then sit down. Listen to me. I am not going anywhere without my son. You don't want me to take you to the police? You say they're in on it? Fine. But you need to tell me what the hell is going on here. You used the word cult. You said my wife was involved. She is. Convince me.
Really?
Yeah, really. Convince you? What's it gonna take, lady? How do you think we've been getting into your house?
She kind of makes a point.
I like the name of the guinea pig. Ivy made sure the alarm at your house was off and that the door was unlocked, and she texted us when you were a few blocks away. Why would she do that to my crazy? Why would my own wife want to make me crazy? You have to ask her that, but she wasn't super thrilled you voted for Jill Stein, I know that. Are you kidding me? That's not a reason. Maybe she just hates you. Just one project we had a bunch. You know all those dead birds that you found on your lawn? We did that all over the city. There was nothing in those trucks. They were water trucks. We killed the birds by poisoning our feeders. Why? To make people paranoid. To scare them and to soften them up. For what? The takeover? This is insane. I am not insane. This is insane.
Yeah.
My wife is not in a fucking cult. Ivy's not the type. She's not a joiner. She hates all organized religion. She doesn't believe in anything. That's kind of how it starts. If you already believed in something, there wouldn't be any room for him. Him? Him who?
This is Beverly Hope coming to you from City Hall. Or any moment, candidates for city council will have their final opportunity to address the terrified citizens of Brookfield Heights. With the election days away, frontrunner Kai Anderson continues to soar in the polls.
There he is.
An unprecedented 16-point lead.
Oh my God, I know him. Not as well as he knows you. He's the one who got the protesters to leave that day. It's because he paid them to be there.
That makes a lot more sense.
Yeah.
They're all members of the cult. No. You can't just join it like it's the AARP. He has to choose you. I've been in love with Harrison since I was 10, but I never knew what love was until I met Kai. I still have to shoot this thing with some definition.
Is everything in your world?
You're just being nice.
I'm not. You don't belong my every expectation. I know I've asked a lot. But a larva bee has to shed its skin to become a queen. It can be painful.
When Kai looked at me, it was better than standing high. It was better than sex. He made me
come down to the biggest set and then go back upstairs. Bye bye, kitty.
Yeah.
Built up a wall of housewives and drag races to anesthetize myself from all the shit in the world. But I hated feeling helpless. I hated myself for being so trapped by feminist expectations. Every day, faced with the failure that I wasn't a successful bitch, that I had no loving husband and 2.5 kids at home to bake a goddamn casserole for, that I was nowhere near having help. And this rage began to build and fester and burn. until Kai finally set me free. He made me feel invincible. Together we were unstoppable.
No, he's saying the same thing as someone else.
Thing would be hilarious if it wasn't so insane.